Hello children, today we are going to read about the Sermon at Benares written by Betty Renshaw. Betty Renshaw was born in Shannon, Mississippi on September 3, 1927. After graduating from Shannon High School, she went on to obtain her Bachelor of Arts degree from Mississippi College and later a Master of Arts from Mississippi University for Women. She taught at the preschool level for several years. And eventually, she was able to pass her experiences on to others by teaching preschool teachers. The Sermon at Benares throws light upon the early life of Lord Buddha, who was originally born as a prince in the royal family. On being exposed to the sufferings of the world, which he was earlier shielded from, he left his princehood and went in search of salvation, thus leaving all the worldly pleasures behind. Upon attaining spiritual awakening, he gave his first sermon in the city of Benares, hereby making a lady named Kisa Gotami realize that men are mortal and a wise person should not grieve at what is bound to happen, for it only enhances pain and suffering. Gautam Buddha was born to a North Indian royal family as a prince and was named Siddhartha Gautama. He was sent to a faraway place when he was 12 years old to study Hindu sacred scriptures. Upon returning 4 years later, he got married to a princess. Soon they both had a son and they continued to live the royal life for about 10 years. The royals were shielded from all the unpleasant experiences of the world until one day, while the prince was out hunting, chanced to see a sick man, an aged man, a funeral procession, and a monk looking for alms. These experiences acted as eye-openers for him, and thus he left all the royalty behind to seek a higher sense of spiritual knowledge. Gautam Buddha went in search of enlightenment for about 7 years before he finally came across a peepal tree and chose to sit under it till he became awakened. When he finally attained salvation after 7 days, he decided to retitle the tree as the Bodhi tree, which means the tree of wisdom, and he himself came to be known as Buddha, which means the awakened. He even began preaching his new realizations, and his first sermon was given in the city of Benares. The city of Benares is known to be sacred as it resides on the banks of the river Ganges. The first sermon he gave was preserved and is famous till date. It gives a new perspective to man's unending sufferings. It talks about a lady named Kisa Gautami, whose son had recently died. Struck with unending pain and sorrow, she took her son door to door, requesting for a wonder drug that could bring his son back to life. Quite obviously, everyone thought that the lady had lost her ability to think clearly. Going on from door to door, she finally came across a man who couldn't offer any medicine, but led her to Shakyamuni, the Buddha. Filled with hope, the lady visited Gautam Buddha and begged him for a cure for her child. Just as the man said Gautam Buddha had a solution, he asked Kisa Gautami to get a handful of mustard seeds. Restored with hope, Kisa Gautami thought it to be a very simple task until Lord Buddha instilled a condition that the mustard seeds must be taken from a house where no one has lost a child, husband, parent, or a friend. Once again, Kisa Gautami went from door to door, but this time she was looking for mustard seeds. Many had mustard seeds to offer, but none of them could fulfill Lord Buddha's condition of having seen no deaths in the family. Upon being asked, people requested her not to remind them of their deepest griefs. Unfortunately, she couldn't find a suitable home to get mustard seeds for his son. All the hope was lost for Kisa Gautami, and thus, in extreme anguish and pain, she found herself a place to ponder at the edge of the road. She continuously watched city lights blinking and observed them till there was just darkness all around. After deep reflection, she realized that man's fate was just like these city lights that flicker and extinguish repeatedly. The cycle of birth and death is nature's way of working. Suddenly, she became conscious as to how selfish she had been in her sorrow, and that one who was born must rest eternally. Men are mortal, and the ones that are immortals have covered a path free from all worldly pleasures. According to Lord Buddha, the life of mortals is troubled because they have not made peace with the fact that the one who is born must rest eternally. There is no way in living being can avoid facing death. Just like a ripe fruit is more prone to falling, an aged mortal is bound to die. Just like all earthen vessels break at some point, so do men. Whether old or young, foolish or wise, death leaves none. The only way death works is by withdrawing the person from the living world, that is, the person ceases to exist. No one has control over death. Neither a father can save his son, nor a kinsman his relative. Just like an ox is taken to the slaughterhouse to be killed, so does death do with mortals, leaving none behind. Thus, the one who knows this truth and doesn't grieve at his loss is the one who has been called wise by Lord Buddha. According to Lord Buddha, one should not grieve, weep, or be miserable at something which is bound to happen, for it will keep man away from obtaining peace of mind. It will only multiply the pain and suffering, thus leading to physical weakness, and moreover, no amount of grief would bring back the dead. It is very important to understand that one must move past feelings like sorrow and grief, as it is the only way that leads to the path of salvation. So we learn the precious lesson from Geesa Gautami's story. Number one, death and sorrow are universal and natural process. Number two, human life is full of suffering, trials and tribulations, and each person must overcome them. And real wisdom is to accept the inevitability of death and continue to move ahead with the journey of life. I hope you've understood the chapter. So see you in the next video. Thank you.